Hello everybody, you are all welcome once again to Fresh Fire Prayer Line, where we keep the fire of the Holy Spirit burning. Today is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad. And as the songwriter said, I will arise on eagle's wings. Precious one, when you and I learn to trust God, He will enable you and I to mount up on eagle's wings. The Bible says that those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Tonight, we are on here to renew our strength, so that in this new month, in this new second season, we'll be able to run and not be weary. We'll walk and we will not faint, because our trust, our confidence is in the name of our Lord God. Tonight is very important night, because not only have we entered into a new month, the month of May, we have also entered a new season, the second season in the calendar of the year. We have finished with the first season, the first quarter, the first 4 months. It is over. Now we are left with another second 4 months, and then we'll be left with the last 4 months, and the year is ended. So whatever needs to be done in our lives is going to be done within the second season and the third season. The first is already passed. During the first season, some people got their breakthroughs. Some people got their deliverance. Some people got their miracles. Some people got answers to their problems. Some people too, they are still waiting patiently. So this is the second season. And God works in seasons. And some of us, our blessings, miracles, healing, deliverance are locked up in these second seasons. That's why the Bible says that the kingdom of God suffers violence, and the violent will take it by force. On Fresh Fire Prayer Line, we don't play games. We take what is ours by force in the name of Jesus Christ. So tonight, we are not only going to be praying concerning just the month of May, but also praying into the month of the second season, which is May, June, July, August. May, June, July, and August. We'll be committing this month before the Lord and asking Him to grant us the grace to be able to serve Him, even in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That's why we are starting our marathon fasting next week, Monday, on the 6th of Monday. Next week, Monday, we are starting our 2 weeks marathon fasting and prayer. 2 weeks marathon fasting of divine grace. Our fasting for this month of May is divine grace, divine grace, divine grace. And grace means unlimited, unmerited favor, unmerited favor. This month of May, God will release into our lives things you don't deserve, things you were not expecting, things you were not even hoping or believing it will happen. Grace means unmerited favor. Divine grace. And the Bible says that His grace is sufficient for us, even in our weakness. So in this month, as we fast and pray, it will be believing God for divine grace, unmerited grace, unmerited favor. No, when you thought that the marriage will never work out, when you thought that you'll never get a job, when you thought that you'll never be healed, when you thought that nothing was going to work out, divine grace, something you did not deserve, will just happen to you because of God's goodness. He will shower on you His grace this month of May. And then for the season, the second season of this year, which is May, June, July, August, the second fasting is we are praying that our destiny, our glory should appear by fire. Our glory, our hidden glory should appear during this 4 months we are left with to finish the second season. That's where we are fasting 2 weeks. The first week is for the month of May. The second fasting is for the second season. We are taking both for the month of May and the whole entire season before God in prayers, believing God that this time of waiting upon Him the Lord will radically change situations in our lives, and we will see His glory. We will see His glory. So if you just joined us, starting from next week, Monday on the 6th, next week, Monday, 6th, we are starting our 2 weeks fasting and prayer. And the title is Divine Grace. 2 weeks fasting and prayer for divine grace. Grace means unmerited, undeserved favor. God will show you His favor in every area of your lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Undeserved favor. Undeserved favor. And it's starting off next week, Monday, from 6 a.m. The fasting is from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. 6 a.m. in the morning, and you break 6 p.m. And during the time of fasting, it is water. You drink holy water, and you eat of the Word of God. I'm going to give you some scriptures which we will be standing on during the time of fasting and prayer. And you'll be digesting the scriptures into your life. You'll be meditating on the scriptures into your life and believing God to show you His undeserved favor in the court case, undeserved favor in your marital problem, undeserved favor to reverse the doctor's report, undeserved favor concerning your education, the exams you've taken, undeserved favor. Something that you did not merit, deserve, God's divine grace. When we talk about grace, grace is what can cause a prostitute Rahab, to become part of the people who Jesus Christ came out from. She was a prostitute, but because of grace, God, Jesus Christ came from her. That is grace. How does God bring a prostitute into the picture? Grace. Grace will cause you to achieve a position, get a job, become somebody from nothing to something. Grace. And people wonder, why you are not qualified? You don't deserve it. You are not. Why did you? How did you even come up by this? You know, you have messed up in your past. Why? How did you end up with this man to marry? This noble man, this nice man, this really God-fearing man, with all your past life. It is divine grace. When God chooses to show you grace, you send in the application. They'll review your application, your resume, and they'll realize that you are underqualified, you don't have the experience, you are not, but divine grace will tell them just to give you the job. Divine grace will just promote you at your workplace. Divine grace will cause your husband to begin to say that, forget about the divorce and separation, I've changed my mind. You have no idea what the grace of God in your life, in my life, can do for us, which will marvel people. How people will look at you and say, "You, I'm better than you, but I don't know why you are enjoying this benefit." Grace. You did not do nothing. You didn't have to do nothing. It is just supernaturally. Your enemies are thought they are finished with you. Then supernaturally, God shows you undeserved favor, which revolutionized your whole situation. And during this month of May, God will show you and I divine grace, undeserved favor. And it is also, our warfare is also going to be using that the stone of God to pull down every giant in our lives. Five. May represents five. January, February, March, April, May. Grace, five. G-R-A-C-E. Grace. David took five stones. Five stones representing Jesus and released it, and the giant came down. During the time of divine grace, every giant in your life will fall down. Every giant, every Goliath in your life will come down in the name of Jesus Christ. And we are starting it next week, Monday. So prepare yourself as we wait upon the Lord with fasting and prayer. Come in believing God to show you undeserved favor. Undeserved favor. Believing Him that He will do something great in your life. From 6 a.m. to 6 p.m., during the time of fasting, it is drinking water and eating the Word of God. Man shall not live by bread alone. Man shall not eat by bread alone. It is not always the food that we eat. It is not always the things you are hearing from the news or the report of doctors and the lawyers and your job. And no. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word. During the time of fasting, you spend quality time digesting, meditating, holding on to the promises of God until God's divine grace begins to rub upon you, until the situations begin to change around you. That's why I told you that during these 2 weeks, five things are we doing, and five also represent the same grace, favor, and pulling down the giant. We are fasting, we are praying, we will be praising the Lord, we will be worshiping God, and we will be giving to the kingdom of God. And you will not escape God's divine visitation during these 2 weeks fasting and prayer. And I told you that this month is not just an ordinary month, because you have ushered yourself into the second season in the year 2013. It is the second season. May begins the second 4 months, and there will be left with the last 4 months, and the year is ended. If you don't redeem the times, you will waste another year. That's why we take it by force. By the time you realize the year is ended, that's why this is the second season. You have to do everything to pray that heaven will look down and release that which is yours. Don't allow this second season to pass by you until you lay hold what God has for you. We'll be fasting, we'll be praying, we'll be praising the Lord, we'll be worshiping the Lord, and we'll be giving to the kingdom of God. During this time, make sure that you don't say negative things from your mouth in this second season. Don't say the negative things about your situations. Only confess the positive. Only make sure that every time you are praising the Lord, because it is the second season, the month where you are praising, worshiping, glorifying God, praying to Him, and things will change, giving to His kingdom until heaven opens. The reason why we give is that if you need deliverance, you can pray and fast. If you need healing, you can pray and fast. But when it comes to heaven opening to you, for God to bring financial prosperity, to rebuke the devourer, to rebuke spirits and demons that attack your finances, you cannot pray to get wealth. You cannot pray to be rich. You cannot pray to get financial advancement in life. It comes by giving. God so loved the world, so He gave. It comes by giving. When you sow, then you get back. Right now, if I tell you to close your hands, you have a fist. With the fist, you cannot receive anything. During this time of giving, you open your hands and you give what you have. And your hands begin to be wide open so that heaven can now fill it. Heaven can now fill it. So don't just give. Give and have a revelation of also receiving. Concerning giving and receiving. You are giving. Colossians in the book of Acts, the Bible says that He gave to the kingdom of God until His giving became a memorial before God in heaven. And God released an angel to visit Colossians, and which brought a change in his life. So during this time of giving, I don't want you to just sow into the ministry. No, you are not sowing into my life. You are not sowing into the festival ministry. If you don't give, God knows how to take care of this ministry. It is just an opportunity for you to provoke heaven to also financially empower you. Because some of us, whether we give or not, the devil has been stealing. No, if you give $50, God can always open a better door. But you hold on to the gift or your seed only to realize that ticket, sickness, accidents, problems here, problems there. By the time you realize 500, 1,000 is gone, the devil has stolen it. What if you are giving to the kingdom, God would have preserved what you have and also given you abundantly. So this time of giving is you giving and believing God that in this 4 months, during this 4 months, May, June, July, August, if there is something before you that needs to be done, as you give, you are telling God to give you the grace, the blessing, the necessary empowerment to be able to accomplish His purpose for your life in this 4 months, the second season. That is the reason behind the giving. If you don't have faith concerning what I'm telling you, don't waste your money by giving to the ministry. Don't, because I don't need your money. This month, I've given more than 1,500 out. So I don't need your money to do anything. So get the revelation. Without the revelation, you will not get results. Don't think you are giving to me or the me. Give, having a covenant with God our Father. This second season, every spirit that is fighting me with lateness in life, stagnation, retrogression, blocking me from making it, causing struggle. This 4 months, by my giving, let heaven open, rebuke the devourers, and break me loose, and bless me enough for me to fulfill my destiny in this second season. And you realize that God's grace will be sufficient. Whatever needs to be done within this second season, God's divine grace will be sufficient for you to be able to do it. That's what I'm saying, that if you don't get the revelation, you don't have faith in it, don't give, because if you don't have faith, you will not receive back. Give only when you have revelation and the Spirit of God leads you, so that you know that you have a covenant with God, He will do it in your life. So during this second season, precious one, we'll be starting our fasting, 2 weeks fasting from Monday. Come, prepare to fast, pray, praise God, worship God, and give. Make sure that during this time, you are filling yourself with the promises of God. Some of us, we've been always talking about the negative. Oh, I'm struggling. It is so hard. Things are not going well. The marriage is this. No. God is doing a new thing. You have entered into a new season. Always positive. I'll be the head and not the tail. I am healed because of the stripes of Jesus Christ. My God is able to supply all my needs according to His riches in glory. I know my God is going to bring peace and unity in this marriage. Let your mouth be filled and seasoned with only the positive things that you are expecting God to do in your life during this second season, and see how God's grace, God's divine grace, will empower you to leap over the limitations, the limits, the restrictions, the boundaries that the devil has set before you. These are revelations, and those who connect to it, their lives will change. So please, it starts from next week, Monday, and during the fasting and prayer, we'll be meeting constantly on the prayer line every evening, according to the Tuesday time. So whatever area you are, we meet from Monday to Thursday, according to the Tuesday time. On Friday, we keep the time as it is. Come prepared with your prayers, praise, fasting, worship, and giving, and let's see how God will change situation in your life, in my life, in this second season. And the scriptures we'll be standing on, let me give you some of the scriptures we'll be standing on. The main scripture for this fasting and prayer, the main scripture will be 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9. 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9. God's grace is sufficient for you, even in your weakness. Divine grace, unmerited favor. 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9. And also Exodus 33 verse 18. Exodus 33 verse 18. That will be for the whole month. The whole month. The second season. Exodus 33 verse 18. Show me your glory. My glory must appear. In this second season, my glory must appear. My glory in my workplace, my glory in my marriage, my glory in my destiny must appear, must show up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Then the last one is Colossians 1, verse 27. Colossians 1, 27. Christ in you is the hope of glory. Jesus Christ in you, your hope, your glory will be manifested. Your glory will be manifested in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Next week, I'm going to give you other scriptures, but these are the main scriptures. 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9. 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9. Exodus 33 verse 18. Exodus 33 verse 18. Then Colossians chapter 1 verse 27. Colossians 1 27. Now some scriptures you can add it as you begin to meditate on the word of God during your time of fasting. Jeremiah 33 verse 3. Jeremiah 33 verse 3. Call unto me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things. So during the time of fasting and prayer, don't just keep quiet. Call upon God. Bring your prayer. Bring your supplication. Bring your need before Him. He says He will answer you. As you call upon Him during the time of fasting, God will answer you. Jeremiah 33 verse 3. Matthew chapter 7 verse 7. Matthew 7 verse 7. It is the ask and it shall be given. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door. During this time of fasting and prayer for divine favor, divine God's grace and God's unmerited favor, as we are asking, we will receive it. As we are seeking, we will find. As you knock, whatever door you are knocking, it will be open. Matthew chapter 7 verse 7. Matthew 7 verse 7. Mark chapter 11, verse 22 to 24. Mark 11, 22 to 24. Mark 11, 22 to 24. Speak to the mountains in your life, and the mountains will be removed. That is the verse. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20. Ephesians 3, verse 20. Ephesians 3, verse 20. He's able to do exceedingly abundantly far above. Believe God for the supernatural. Ephesians 3, verse 20. Ezra chapter 8, verse 21. Ezra chapter 8, verse 21. Talking about God's divine protection for you during this second season and the month of May. And also Ezra chapter 8, verse 31 to 32. Ezra 8, 31 to 32. Then the last one is Isaiah 58, verse 6. Talking about the deliverance God will bring to you. He will break yokes from your life. He will break chains from your life. He will break every curse from your life. He will heal you from sicknesses. They are all in Isaiah chapter 58, verse 6. These are scriptures. During this time of fasting, meditate on it. Meditate on them. Speak them into your life. Pray and stand on them and see how God will change and revolutionize your life in the time of fasting and prayer, even in the mighty name of Jesus. So if you just joined us, we are starting our fasting next week, Monday, from on the 6th. It's going to be 2 weeks, and it's the marathon fasting for divine grace. Divine grace, which means unmerited favor. God will show you favor in the time of fasting. And it is from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. During the fasting, we drink holy water. When you break, you can now eat. During the time of your fasting, you read the word, you pray, and bring your prayers and your needs before the Lord. Make sure that you go to our website, www.freshfireprayer.com. www.freshfireprayer.com. You see on our website, mail letter to. Mail letter to. You know, put in your covenant seed, believing God to financially bless you and also to break every spirit that is trying to block you from fulfilling your destiny during this second season. Don't write too much prayer requests. It is about something which needs to be done in the second season, the second 4 months. What is it that needs to be done in this second 4 months? Just put it there, sow the seed into it, and stand on Exodus chapter 33, verse 18. Exodus 33, verse 18. Show me your glory. Just write on it. Show me your glory. Let my glory appear by fire. Let my glory appear by fire. And then send it. I tell you, if you don't have faith and you don't believe in it, I don't need your money. Don't do it. Only those who want a curse of limitation, stagnation, with something holding you back every day. You are working hard, but you are never making it. Something seems to be pulling you back. This is the time to sow and to break that limitation, break that delay in your life, and provoke heaven to open the door for you to fulfill your destiny in this second season. It is only for those who have faith, because you have to have faith in order to receive. If you give and you don't have faith, you will not receive back. Give with revelation and make a covenant so that you can tell God, Lord, I gave to you. You didn't give it to Brake. I gave to you. I didn't give to the ministry. I gave into your kingdom. Lord, you must answer. You are a faithful God. You must answer me and deliver me from whatever chains is hindering me. In this second season, I want you to liberate me from every chain, every shackles, every delay, anything holding me back. And let me fulfill my purpose in this second season. You believe God. You sow into his kingdom. Last Sunday, a woman came to me, Brother K. I found out why I have a business and nothing is working. I said, what is it? In my family, we serve an idol. And we used to sacrifice to the idol. We used to give the idol animals and all animal sacrifice and all those things. But now we have become Christians. We are not sacrificing to the idols anymore. Now the idol, the demons in the idols are angry that we are no more giving them the sacrifice. So they have begun to block everybody in the family from prospering. Even demons or idols demand sacrifice in order to make their people prosper. And that's what God also is telling you, that give your tithe, give your offering, that he may open the windows of hell. Even witchcraft and demons, they always demand sacrifices so that they may be blessing their agents. In the same way with the things of God, if you want him to constantly preserve your job, preserve your health, you have to give and believe God, make a covenant with Him, and you see how God will protect you. Because even if you don't give, you will just allow the devil to be stealing from you through sicknesses, through tickets, through your car breaking, this breaking and that breaking. By the time you realize, the devil is using other means to steal all your money. Give and let God protect you this second season, and let heaven empower you with blessing. Blessing simply means God has given you supernatural ability to succeed. When you pray, and also when you are sending your offering or donation, say, God, bless me. You are telling God to give you the power to succeed in whatever you need to do. Blessing gives one the power to succeed no matter the resistance. A curse programs you to fail. No matter the condition they put you in, a curse will cause you to fail. But a blessing will position you or program you to succeed. Let us provoke God. Five things. We are praying, we are fasting, we are praising Him, we are worshiping Him, and we are giving. During this time, no negative words from your mouth. When somebody asks you, how are you doing? No matter how your situation is bad, say, it is well. During this month, when we meet, all we ask, every day, it is well. It is well. Today is the day the Lord has made. I'll rejoice and be glad in it. It is well with my soul. It is well with me this season. I am the head and not the tail. I am above and not beneath. I am prosperous. I'm promoted and not demoted. Speak the word of life into your situation and see how this second season things will begin to work for you, because you are connected to divinity, and His grace shall be sufficient for you, even in the name of Jesus Christ. Our website again, www.freshfireprayer.com, and you'll see in the page mail letter to my name, and this, or you can send me an email and I'll give you the address. Plug in, make sure you don't miss the fasting and prayer, and the Lord God Almighty will meet us. We meet every evening from next week to pray according to the Tuesday time. Don't miss this opportunity for your life and destiny to change. I know what I'm talking about. I know the grace of God that He has bestowed upon me ever since we started giving. When we started giving for February, it was like a joke. I sold into it. Today, I started a project. I'm done with it. I'm about to start another project. That's why I'm believing God to empower me, bless me to be able to finish it also. I started one some years ago. It is still somewhere. I'm now going to pick it again and do it again, because now I am, God's blessing is granting me the divine grace. So also tap into divine grace, and God's grace will give you supernatural ability to excel where the devil programmed you to fail. And only do, this is for those who believe. If you don't believe, don't even do it, because you'll not have results. We don't need your money. God doesn't need your money. God works on goals. No, the floor is goals already, and He holds everything. It is just an opportunity for God to bless us. He says that let the storehouse, let the kingdom of God be prosperous, and He will bless us. Make sure that you are praising God. Please praise God every day. Worship God every day. Read the Bible, meditate on it, and you see your situation will change. No negativity in this second season. Amen. Let me give you the word, and then we'll begin to pray for tonight. Can somebody read the scripture for tonight? When I just woke up, I didn't even know what to say, but God gave me a word, and we are going to stand on that word for tonight. Isaiah 43 verse 19. Can somebody read Isaiah 43 verse 19? Press star 6-1. Isaiah 43 verse 19. Isaiah chapter 43 verse 19. Okay. 6:36. Hallelujah. Go ahead. Start from 18. Amen, amen, amen. Please go ahead and still read. Read until I tell you to stop. Verse 20. Amen, amen. That they may proclaim my praise. I want you to read it again from 18. Now read it boldly, read it loudly, read it authoritatively. Mm-hmm. That they may proclaim my praise. God bless you for reading. Isaiah chapter 43 verse 18. Just when I woke up, getting ready, God just dropped this word into my spirit. And it is because God wants you and I to know that because we've entered into a new month and a new season, it's so crucial. The reason why people are going through years and years and years and things are not changing because they are not redeeming the times and seasons. They see every day like every day is the same. Every day is not the same. Just last month, and this month is entirely different. Last month was part of a first season in the year 2030. That first season is over. The first 4 months is over. So if you were dwelling on the things of last January, February, March, April, you are wasting your time. You have entered into a new month of May and a new season, starting with May, June, July, August. It's a new season, the second season in the calendar of God. He's about to do a new thing. So you have to now reprogram your mind that, hey, I've entered into a new season. God is about to do a new thing in my life. So the old thing, the first season is past and gone. Maybe the first season wasn't your season for divine visitation, because God has times and season for visitation and visiting us with his blessing and his package of blessing. But the first season is gone. So this month of May is not just another month. It is not even part of the month of, it's not even part of the first season. It is part of the new second season God has just ushered us in. And here is what God is speaking to you. I don't know what you are going through in your marriage, and I don't know what situation you are experiencing in your finances. I don't know what you are going through with your health, but God says that do not remember the former things. Do not remember the former things. Forget about the first season. It's past. January is past. February is past. April is past. You have entered into a new season and a new month. Do not remember the former things. People are still in bondage of the past. That's why we cannot receive the newness of what God is doing. Just yesterday, I was speaking to a lady, and Brother K, she's begun, Brother K, I'm struggling. I said, hey, you were struggling in the second season, in the first season. We are in a new month, May. We are in a new season, second season. Why are you still talking like last season? Why are you still talking like last month? I know that the difference between last month and this month is only about 2 days, but you have entered into a new season. A new change, a new dimension, a new thing that God is doing in your life. So don't talk like the old. That's what I'm saying, that during this time, this second season, those who will learn these 5 things I've spoken about, they are going to change their destiny. They are going to fulfill their purpose. The 5 things, prayer, fasting, praising God. Stop complaining about your issues. Praise God. Worship God. You praise God for what he has done for you. You worship him for who he is and give to his kingdom and see how these 5 elements will change your destiny. This is a revelation to change destinies, change situations. Do not remember the former things. Forget about the old things. Forget about your struggle. Forget about your unemployment. Forget about what your husband told you last month. Forget about the situation going on at your workplace. Forget about what you're expressing in your body. You have entered a new month, a new season, second season. God says that he's about to do a new thing. Now consider the things of old. Forget about the things of old. Behold, I do a new thing. I do a new thing. God says he is about to do a new thing. I embrace it. I embrace it. Lord, I thank you that you are about to do a new thing in my life. I thank you that you are about to do a new thing in Fresh Fire Ministry. I thank you that you are about to do a new thing in my family. You embrace the word of God. Please, this is not just words. These are life. You have to personalize it and say, Lord, I thank you that no matter what I'm going through, I know you are about to do a new thing. So I'm going to praise you. I'm going to worship you. I'm going to fast and pray and give. I'm going to hold on to your word. Behold, I do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Now. It begins now in this month of May. Now in this month of May, beginning the second season. Now. Do you believe that now things are about to change? Do you believe? The first season, somebody got her debt canceled and got almost a lot of thousands of dollars cleared off just supernaturally. That was her season, first season. Now you have entered into a new season. Do you believe that this now means that you are going to be pregnant during this 4 months? Do you believe that now means that you are going to get the job during this month and then during this 4 months? Now, do you believe that God is going to connect you with people who will come into your life and begin to multiply your destiny with good things? Now, do you believe that God is about to open a new door for your ministry, for your family? Now, do you believe? Now, it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? You will know it. If you are expecting it, only those who expect receive. If you are expecting it, you will know it. You will know it when it happens. So be in expectation. Do these 5 things and be in expectation. Shall you not know it? I even will make the road a wilderness. I will even make a road in the wilderness. Where there's wilderness and everything is crooked and there's wilderness whereby people lack direction. They don't know what to do with their lives, their destinies. God will begin to make a road for you. And when there's a road, there's a path, there's direction. Somebody, God is going to give you direction for your destiny, direction for your marriage, direction for your children, direction for your finances during this second season. He's going to make a road, a path for you to walk on to receive his blessing. Now, I will even make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Rivers in the desert. Desert means dryness, barrenness, fruitlessness. On productivity, but now water will begin to spring upon your life. The dew of heaven will rest upon you. Things will begin to take shape in your life. Things that were meaningless, things that were blocking you. Now the rivers of God will begin to run into your life and situations will change. You have to believe this. It is not just words. It is for those who will believe. They will receive it and it will manifest in their lives. The beast of the field shall honor me, even the beast, the jackals and the ostrich, because I will give water in the wilderness. If even animals are going to be blessed by what God is going to do, how much more his children? And the rivers in the desert, to give drink to my people, my chosen. Are you not a chosen child of God? God says, I'm about to give you drink. I'm going to quench your thirst. I'm going to fill you so that you begin to be fruitful. That's what I'm saying, that during this time, whatever spirit of delay, stagnation, limitation, barriers, hindrances, opposition. This second month, that yoke must break. That chain must break. That limitation, that curse must be reversed because God is about to do you good and do a new thing in your life. He says that these people I have formed for myself, they shall declare my praise. They shall declare my praise. You will have something to praise God in this second season, but it all begins with change your mindset. The reason why most of us are still in limitation is because we talk limited. The devil has bound us, the devil is fighting us, and the devil wants us to always say the negative. And we have ended up always lamenting and talking negatively. And so our conditions are not changing. This 4 months, from now on, that's what I'm saying. When somebody asks you, how are you doing? How is your marriage? How is your children? How is your finances? The only thing you can say, it is well. By God's grace, it is well. It is well because you know it is going to be well. Don't allow negative confessions to come from your mouth. stand on the promises and say, Lord, I thank you because you have made me rich. I thank you that you have given me money in my account. I thank you that you have paid the bills. I thank you that you have healed my body. I thank you that you have restored my family, my marriage. I thank you that you have changed my husband. But you come and ask somebody, how is your marriage? Ask for my husband. Ask for my husband. You know what? I want to even divorce. You are making your situation worse. How are you feeling? Oh, I'm feeling pain. It is, oh, how are you feeling? By God's grace, I receive my healing. I'm doing well by God. You are declaring your healing. Have you gotten a job? It is coming. My best job is coming. It's on the way. It's on the way. You always praise God for even the things you have not seen. For the Bible says that, no, we speak things which are not as though they were. During this 4 months, if I can get you to walk in revelation and in faith, to change you for good, and what, that's what I'm saying, it is the amount of grace on unmerited favor. Grace is what you did not deserve will happen to you if you can fulfill these 5 things: prayer, fasting, praising God, worshiping God, and giving. Prayer, fasting, praising God, worshiping God, and giving. Don't allow negative things to come out from you. Praise God, worship Him, praise Him, give, pray, fast. See how divine will visit you and your situation. He says, I'm doing a new thing. There's a song in my country which is, do something new in my life, something new in my life, something new in my life. Oh Lord, do something new in my life, something new in my life, something new in my life. Oh Lord, do something new in my life, something new in my life, something powerful, something wonderful. Do something new in my life, something gracious in my life, something wonderful in my life, oh Lord. And it says that yesterday is gone, another day has come. Do something new in my life. Yesterday is gone, another day has come. Do something new in my life. Do something new in my life. Something new in my life, something new in my life. Oh Lord, do something new in my life, something new in my life, something new in my life. Oh Lord, yesterday is gone, another day has come. Today, this month of May, another day has come. This new season has come. So do something new, something wonderful, something glorious, something supernatural, something amazing, something marvelous, something amazing, wonderful in my life. Yesterday is gone, another day has come. Do something new in my life. Let it be your song and be in expectation as God says, I will do a new thing. Agree with God. Agree with God concerning your marriage. Agree with God concerning your finances. Agree with God concerning your deliverance. Agree with God concerning the restoration of your family and your marital destiny. Agree with God that God is about to do a new thing. It is for those who believe. Those who believe, if you believe, you shall see the glory of the Lord. If you believe, you shall receive the power of God at work in your life. Today, do you believe that God is about to do something new in this new season? In this new month, yes, you are going to get a job. Yes, God is going to provide all your needs according to your riches and glory. Yes, God is going to heal you from that sickness. Yes, God is going to bring back your husband. Yes, God is going to touch your children. Yes, God is going to deliver your spouse from that court case, your children from that court case. Yes, God is going to provide your needs. You are afraid. Lord, how am I going to settle the bills? How am I going to settle the bills when I don't even have a job? God says that I'm doing a new thing. God, what is going to happen now that I'm experiencing heat at the workplace? God says, I'm doing a new thing. Tonight, believe. The word of God has come. God is doing a new thing. Agree with God. Agree with God. Agree with God.
That's what I'm saying, that this month we can't entertain complaining, murmuring, negativity. Just praise God, just worship God, just fast, just pray, just give to His kingdom and be in expectation that God are expecting the new thing. You said you make a road, you make a road, you make a road in the wilderness, in the wilderness. Father, I need a road to be made in this marriage. It looks like a wilderness right now. Father, make a road so that this marriage will begin to work out. Father, I need a road to be made in my finances. It's a wilderness. Make a road for me. Father, I need a road in my education. Make a road for me. Do you believe God? This is how you pray. This is how you fast and you hold on to the word of God. He says that I will cause water to spring. I'll cause water to spring in the wilderness, in the desert. Father God, there is desert in my life. I'm working, but I don't have any money. Father, I don't even have a job. Wilderness, wilderness, unproductivity, wilderness, wilderness. Nothing is working for me. Struggle, frustration, harassment, here and there. Father, let your water, let your living water, let your living water begin to flow in my life. Let me experience your abundance. Oh God, you can do it. I believe, so I receive it. Jesus, do something new in my life. This is the word of God for somebody tonight. What man cannot do, God can do it. But you have to believe. If you still hold on to your past, then you are your own problem. You are your own problem if you don't want to allow your spirit to begin to agree with Jesus. Some of us are coming online, but we don't believe. We are coming online, and you let us finish praying. Let us finish praying with this word, with our prayer, and let us say, let's give testimony. And somebody will still want to talk about the negative situation they are going through. They don't believe. How do you hear this word? How do you pray and still hold on to the past? That is unbelief. That's why God says that, son, don't even be praying for people on the prayer line, because it's a sheer unbelief. No matter how you spend 3 hours, sometimes we will spend 4 hours on the phone, and immediately we shut the phone. Somebody will still call me wanting another prayer. Where is your faith? Do you believe Jesus? Do you have faith? Do you hold on to His word? Somebody, as you speak the word, they don't even believe. It's just, they're hearing it from 1 year. It's going, how do you come into miracles? Precious one, I've been a Christian for some time now, and I realize that it is not just there. No, it is about faith. If you can have faith, if you can hold on to faith, if you can hold on to Jesus and hold trust in Him, He will surprise you. He will surprise you. I've given you 5 secrets. Pray. Fast. Praise God. I can't overemphasize. Praise God. Praise Him for even the little things that He's doing in your life. Oh God, I thank you. Even you have given me a dollar, I thank you. You have given me this job, I thank you, because I know through this job you are about to do something great. I thank you because I know my husband was not even coming home, but now he's coming, even coming late. But I thank you. You are praising God. You are not complaining. Worshiping Him. Lord, I worship you for who you are. You praise God for what He has done for you. You worship Him for who He is. And then you give, Lord, I give to your kingdom. I give to you, believing you that you are going to use this seed to multiply my destiny in this 4 months. And how can heaven miss you? How can heaven miss a saint, a child of God, who is operating under this revelation? How? 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 That's what I'm saying. This month, I've given more than 1,500. I don't even feel it, because the more I give, the more I receive. Precious one, walk in revelation. If you continue with, I am struggling, and it is hard, and it is difficult, and I'm there, you are going nowhere. The year will pass again, and you'll be in your same state. Change your position. Change today. I want you to change your mind, and God will change your life. Change your mind. See God to be the God who is able to do all things. Magnify God in your life, and let all your problems be little. The devil has succeeded in making problems magnified in our lives, and everything has shrunk. Tonight, I've spoken to you the word of God. Those who believe, they will receive from God this second month. We are going to pray, and I just want you to pray right now that, Father, do something new in my life. Lord, take away unbelief. Take away faithlessness. Take away doubt, and help me to believe in your word. And if you have your scriptures, which you should have, open to Isaiah chapter 43, verse 18. Isaiah 43, verse 18. And you have to now begin to pray the scriptures into your life. Begin to tell the Lord to do a new thing in your life, to make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Make road in the wilderness and rivers in the and road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Begin to stand on the scriptures and tell the Lord to do something new in your marriage, something new in your health, something new with your children, something new with your finances. Lord, do something new. Today is another day. This month is another month. This season is a new season. Father, please do something. Do something. Do something glorious. Do something wonderful. Do something fantastic. Do something amazing. Do something to surprise my enemies. Do something to even embarrass me. Embarrass me with your miracles. Embarrass me with your glory. Embarrass me, oh God, with your goodness. In this second month, in this month of May, I want you to open your mouth and begin to tell the Lord that you have heard his word and you believe in his word, that you are going to believe him, that he's going to do a new thing in your life. Just open your mouth and begin to pray. I've spoken the word. You got to pray right now in the name of Jesus. Tell the Lord to do something new in your life.
Thank you.
About to do. Faith requires that you praise God before you see it. Faith
unbelief want to see before they believe. But faith, those who walk in faith, they haven't seen, but they are praising God already. Thanking God for this new month that you have gotten the job. Thanking God in this season that you are becoming pregnant. Thanking God in advance that you have already received your deliverance. You have already received your breakthrough. That is people who walk in faith. They don't see before they believe. They believe in their spirit, and then it materializes in the physical. We are going to thank God. I told you, praise and worship is part of our five major keys. We are going to praise God. You praise God for what He's doing in your life. You worship Him for who He is. We are going to praise and worship God for this month of May and this blessed month, second season. I tell you the truth, a lot of people wanted to see this second season, see the month of May. Unfortunately, they were far better than you, but they are dead. They are dead. But by God's grace, you are alive. Once there's life, there's hope. And once there's hope, God is about to do a new thing. So we are going to go before the Lord and thank God for what He is about to do in this new season. Worship the name of Jesus. Worship the name of God. Glorify Him. Magnify Him. Exalt His name. Thank Him that He has, no matter what you've been going through, He has given you a new season. He's bringing you to a new season. He's about to do a new thing in your life. So begin to thank Him. Now, Father, I thank You that You have healed my body from my sickness. I thank You that You have given me the job. I thank You that You have provided all my needs. I thank You that You have taken care of my bills. I thank You that You have restored this marriage. Thank God in advance. Bless His holy name. Give Him all the glory. Give Him all the honor. Give Him all the adoration. Praise His name. Magnify Him and let Him know that He's the only one who is in control of your life and your destiny. And you appreciate Him so much. Lift up your voice and begin to praise Him.
session started.
Amen. 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 When we read Hebrews chapter 6, Hebrews chapter 6, verse 13 to 14 and 15, the Bible says, "For when God made a promise to Abraham," Hebrews chapter 6, I would like somebody to read it for us. Hebrews, just press star 6 and 1, Hebrews chapter 6, 13 to 15. Press star 6 and 1, 858. You can go ahead and read.
Praise the Lord. Is that Hebrews chapter 6?
Yeah, Hebrews chapter 6, verse 13. 13 to 15.
"Because he swore by no other greater, he swore by himself, saying, 'Surely blessing I will bless you, and multiplying I will multiply you.' And so, after you have patiently endured, he obtained the promise."
Amen.
"For men..."
That's okay, that's okay, that's okay. That's what I want us to meditate and reflect on it. Hebrews chapter 13, verse, Hebrews chapter 6, verse 13, 6, verse 13. "For when God made a promise to Abraham," and tonight God has made a promise to us that, "Behold, I do a new thing." Because he could not swear by no one greater. He swore by himself, saying, "Surely, blessing I will bless you, and multiplying I will multiply you." And so, after he had patiently endured, he obtained the promise. That is Abraham. When Abraham had patiently endured problems with us, Christian, modern Christian is microwave miracles. Microwaves breakthrough, microwave. We can't patiently endure to obtain the promise. Yes, God has given us the promise, but you have to patiently, with fasting, prayer, praising, worshiping, giving, obtain the promise. Tonight, I've told you about this four season, this second season and the 4 months, what we have to do and what God wants to do in our life. We are going to pray that, "Father, let your promises in my life come to pass. Lord, let me be patient and let me attain the promise. Lord, your word says that in blessing you blessed Abraham and in multiplying you multiplied Abraham. So, Father God, in this 4 months, in this 4 months, which is the second season, starting from the month of May, please, in blessing, bless me. In blessing, bless me. In blessing, bless me. In multiplying, multiply me." And if you are telling God to bless you and multiply you, when God blesses you, he brings peace in your marriage. When God blesses you, he brings peace in your family. When God blesses you, he gives you financial ability to set your bill. When God blesses you, he doesn't bless you for the devil to torment and afflict your body. When God blesses you, he gives you divine healing. When God blesses you, he changes situations in your life. When God blesses you, the fight that you are fighting, the struggle that you are going through, the storm that is going through in your life will cease. So, Lord God Almighty, in this second season, please, I'm holding you on to your promise that you're about to do a new thing in my life. In blessing, bless me. In blessing, bless me. If some of you knew the revelation of what blessing is, you would have prayed it crazily. Because when blessing comes upon your life, it means that God has programmed you to succeed, programmed you to be above all that your enemies are doing against you. In blessing, bless me, and in multiply me. So, Father God, in this 4 months, as I praise you, as I worship you, as I fast and pray, as I give to your kingdom, Father, in blessing, bless me. In blessing, bless me. Bless my marriage. Bless my children. Bless my health. Bless my finances. Bless my job. Bless my destiny. Bless me, oh God. Bless me, oh God. In multiply me. Let me be fruitful. Let me multiply. Let things begin to work out. Let me begin to succeed wherever I failed in the past. In blessing, bless me. Father, I've been looking for a life partner for so long. But in your blessing and in your multiplication, let me find my husband. In your blessing,
blessing, in your multiplication, let me be pregnant. In your blessing, in your multiplication, let me find a good job. In your blessing, in your multiplication, deliver me from demons and witchcraft. In your blessing, in your multiplication, heal my body from this sickness. In your blessing, in your multiplication, restore this family, restore this marriage, restore my children, restore my husband. In blessing, these are all packages of blessing. It says that God made a promise to Abraham. And when Abraham had patiently endured, how do you endure patiently? Fasting, praying, and waiting on the Lord. That's what we are doing tonight. So God said that surely I will bless you and I will multiply you. We are going to pray that, Father, in this second season, don't pass me by. Lord Jesus, don't pass me by. In blessing, bless me. In blessing, bless me. In multiplying, multiply me. Touch my life. Touch my destiny. Change my situation. Begin to open your mouth and claim the promise and claim the blessing and claim the multiplication in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let the saints begin to pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh God Almighty, bless us, oh God. Bless us, oh God. In this month of January, in the name of Jesus Christ, in this new season, begin to bless us. Begin to bless us. Begin to multiply. I'm
session started.
Amen. 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 Can somebody read Proverbs chapter 16, verse 13? Proverbs 16, verse 13. Start 6 and 1. Press start 6 and 1. Proverbs 16, verse 3. When you stand on the word of God and you pray, heaven definitely must answer. Okay, we have 858. I think you are on. You can go ahead and begin to read.
Proverbs 16?
Yeah. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 3.
Verse 8?
Verse 16:3. Can you read again? Can you read again? Amen. God bless you for reading the word of God. Simple but very profound. Simple word but very profound. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 3. The Bible admonishes us. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 3. Let it be part of your verses for the first. Commit to the Lord whatever you do. Commit to the Lord whatever you do. And He will establish your plans. He will establish your plans. Commit to the Lord whatever you do. And He will establish your plans. The problem why many are not establishing nothing in their lives is because many of the things they are doing were never committed to God. When I was about to start this ministry, it took me 1 year committing it to God, fasting and praying. For 1 year, praying that Lord God Almighty, don't let me fail when I start this ministry. 1 year, fasting and praying, Lord, this ministry, as it starts, please, commit your ways to the Lord, and He will establish your plans. People have entered into marriages, they are not establishing their marriage. They didn't commit it to the Lord. People have started businesses, they didn't commit to the Lord, so their business is never established. Today is up, tomorrow is down. People have entered into many things, and they are never established. They don't commit it to the Lord. They stand up, they have an idea, and they just go and do it. And yet we call ourselves Christians. Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and He will establish your plans. He will establish. When something is established, whether there's tsunami, whether there's earthquake, whether it is depression, repression, stagnation, whatever it is, economic meltdown, they are established, they are still moving on. They are not moved by situation. They are established by God. They are established by God. They remain. People will rise, people will fall, people will come, people will go, but they remain constant because they are established. And God wants you to be established in your marriage, established in your business, established with your education, established with your finances, established. So we have to commit whatever we do to the Lord in prayers. Another version says that commit your actions, the things that you do, your actions, commit your actions to the Lord so that your plans will succeed. The reason why people are failing, the reason why we are failing in many things is because we are not committing our actions, the things we are doing to God in prayers. So we are failing. We are being defeated by the adversary. But when you commit your ways, that's why we are about to commit the month of May and commit the second season before the Lord. That, oh, you God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, I am committing this month, may you establish me. I am committing this month, may you make me succeed in this month. I am committing this second season before you, may you establish me this season. I am committing this season before you, may you let me succeed. Let me be multiplying, let me be fruitful, let me advance, let me break forth, break through, break out to fulfill your destiny. Lord, I'm committing this month. I'm committing the second season before you. I am committing my marriage before you. I am committing my educational pursuit before you. I'm committing this exams before you. I'm committing this marital proposal before you. I'm committing this business before you. I'm committing my husband before you. I'm committing my wife before you. I'm committing my health before you. I'm committing my pregnancy before you. Commit your ways. That's why I told you that as you give, don't just give. Give with meaning. Give with revelation. Lord, during this 4 months, I want you to do something unique. So, Lord, I'm committing these specific things before you. Help me be within this 4 months to accomplish this and see how God will supernaturally give you all the things you need. Because he says that if you commit your whatever you do to him, he will establish you and he will make you succeed. You stand on the word. You have prayed the word. How can God fail? How can God fail you? How can you fail in what you start? So you are going to pray. If you within this month, there are things that need to be done and you know them, commit them before the Lord. If within this 4 months, this second season, there are something before God has placed in your heart or a vision you have and which you want to do, this is the time for you to commit it before the Lord and ask the Lord to bless it so that he establishes you and help you to succeed. Whatever you are about to do, this is the time to commit it before the Lord. Commit your actions, commit your plans, commit your decisions, commit your choices. Whatever you are about to do, your actions, whatever you are planning to do, commit it. Whatever project, whatever dreams that you have for the 4 months, the second season, this month, commit it before you. Some of you are going for interview. Commit it before the Lord. Some of you are waiting for them to call you back. Commit it before the Lord. Some of you are, whatever is in your life, your finances, commit every action before God. Don't just step out there and do it. Otherwise, you'll not be established. Otherwise, you'll not succeed. Because we have an enemy who wants to make sure you are defeated, you are not established, and you fail. But if you commit it before the Lord, he will establish you and cause you to succeed. Begin to lift up your voice and begin to commit your family, commit your mind, commit your finances, commit your whatever needs to be committed to God in prayers. Commit it and tell him to establish you and tell him to help you to succeed this month of May and this second season. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, lift up your voice and begin to pray. In
Jesus. Q&A session is over.
Thank you.
Q&A session started.
Amen, 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 amen. Our next prayer, we are going to pray and soak ourselves under the covering of the precious blood of Jesus Christ as we have entered into a new month. I want you to soak yourself, your family, your body, soul, and spirit, your houses, your cars, your properties under the covering of the blood of Jesus Christ and declare that no weapon fashioned against you this month, no weapon fashioned against you this second season will ever prosper. That because of the fact that you are covered and sealed by the blood of Jesus, and it says as a Passover, no weapon fashioned against you will ever prosper. I want you to tonight begin to soak yourself, sprinkle the blood upon your properties, sprinkle the blood upon your life, your family, your children, your marriage, your finances, that the blood of Jesus Christ will seal you, protect you from the devourer, from the enemy, from the waster, who comes roaring like a lion seeking for whom he will devour. Tell the Lord that through the blood he should protect you. The blood of Jesus Christ scares the devil from us. The blood of Jesus Christ rebukes the devil on our behalf. When the devil sees the blood, it says as a Passover, we have entered into a new month, and the devil has a new trap set for us. But by the raising of the blood, no weapon fashioned against you will ever prosper. In this 4 months, whatever the devil is planning against you, your family, your finances, your marriage, your destiny, that the blood of Jesus Christ will erase, will nullify, will negate all the plans of the enemy against you. Say this after me and begin to plead the blood. Immerse yourself and your family under the blood of Jesus. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, I immerse myself under the covering of the precious blood of Jesus. I immerse myself in this month of May under the covering of the precious blood of Jesus. I immerse my family under the covering of the precious blood of Jesus Christ. I immerse my property under the covering of the precious blood of Jesus. I immerse my wife, my children. I immerse my job, my finances. I immerse my loved ones under the covering of the precious blood of Jesus Christ. I sprinkle the blood of Jesus Christ all over my properties. I sprinkle the blood of Jesus Christ. Blood of Jesus. Blood of Jesus. Enter into my body, soul, and spirit. Blood of Jesus. Enter into my body, soul, and spirit. And protect me from every arrows. Protect me from every spells. Protect me from every traps. Protect me from every demons. Protect me from every witchcraft. Blood of Jesus Christ. Blood of Jesus Christ. I immerse myself under the covering of the blood. I immerse myself under the covering of the blood. The precious blood. In this month of May, I'm covered by the blood. In this second season, I'm covered by the blood. My children are covered. My finances is covered. My destiny is covered. My life is covered. I hide myself in the blood of Jesus. I hide myself in the blood of Jesus. In the pool of Jesus. In the pool of Jesus. I swim in it. I swim in it. I cover myself. I cover my children. I cover my finances. I cover my loved ones. I cover my properties. Into the blood. Into the blood. Begin to plead the blood of Jesus Christ. Cover yourself under the covering.
Q&A session is over. I'm going to go to the hospital. Q&A session started.
Thank you for the blood. 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 We have entered into a new month and a new season. Very crucial. One is the current month we are in, and the second one is the fourth season, the 4 months. The 4 months ahead of us, we are going to pray for supernatural strength, supernatural ability, supernatural grace. Yes, we got anointing for the first season. It is past. You have entered into a new season. You need to be filled with the Holy Spirit. You need to be filled with power. You need to be filled with the anointing of God upon your life. When the Holy Spirit comes, He comes to empower you, embolden you, strengthen you, and grant you supernatural ability to do the extraordinary. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you, the Bible says that, touch not my anointing. When it comes, it anoints you and begins to repel all forces of darkness from you. When the anointing of God comes upon you, you are able to break every limitation, barriers, stagnation, curses upon your life. So we are going to pray that today, God is a consuming fire. The fire of the Holy Ghost will rest upon us, that we will also be ablaze. Flies do not play around fire. Demons cannot play around fire because they are afraid and terrified about the fire of God. You want to be hot for Jesus Christ. You want to be on fire for Him. You want to be set ablaze for Him. You want your prayer life. You want your Bible studies. You want your fasting. You want the reading of the Word of God, the doing, the obedience of the Word of God to be intact because you are on fire. You are filled and full of the Holy Ghost, full of the anointing, full of the power of God in your life. When you are full of the power of God, whenever you pray, signs and wonders, whenever you pray, heaven hears you. Whenever you pray, demons and witches are afraid and terrified because fire proceeds out of your mouth to destroy your enemies. We are going to pray for the infilling. The Bible says that those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Those who wait upon the Lord, tonight we are going to renew our strength in the name of Jesus Christ by receiving fresh anointing. They shall run and never be weary. In this month of May, you will never be weary. In this 4 months, in this second season, you will never be weary. While others are giving up, while others are quitting, while others are frustrated, while others are sad and depressed and frustrated, the Spirit of God in you will always give you constant joy, constant laughter, constant empowerment. But you need the Holy Spirit to be, you need to be full of the Holy Spirit. And right now, so I realize that some of you are Christians, you have received, the Spirit of God is in you, all right, but you haven't received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And it is important that as a child of God, you receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking in tongues. The evidence of speaking in tongues. And so if you are on this phone line and you are a Christian, all right, you cannot be a Christian until you are filled with the Spirit of God. When Jesus Christ saw the disciples before He went to heaven, He breathed upon them and said, "Receive ye the Holy Spirit." And that time they received the Spirit of God inside of them. When you become a child of God, it is the Spirit of God that begins to draw you to Jesus. You can't be a Christian until God's Spirit draws you. He says that you can't come to me, I drew you to me. He calls you until you can receive Him. So you have the Holy Spirit. But when we talk about the baptism of the Holy Ghost, it comes with the evidence of speaking in tongues. And that's when signs and wonders and miracles begin to follow you. So some of you have the infilling of the Holy Spirit because you are born again, you are a believer. You couldn't have been a child of God without the Holy Spirit. But you now need the baptism of the Holy Fire of God. The Bible says John the Baptist came baptizing with water, but Jesus Christ has come baptizing with the Holy Ghost and with fire. So if tonight you want to receive the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues, I'm going to pray for you. And today you can begin to also speak in tongues, so that when, because some of the prayers we pray, if you pray in tongues, you speak mysteries. You are able to, so you don't, the things you are saying, you may not understand, but God understands it. And with time, God will give you interpretation to your tongues. And then it will lead you to prophecies. It will lead you to the miracles. It will lead you to healing. It will lead you to other gifts. But it all begins with the speaking in tongues. So tonight, as we pray, those of you who want to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues, I want you to say this after me. And then believe and begin to open your mouth as we pray. And then you realize that it will begin to take over. It will begin to take over, and you begin to speak in this strange language. And you may not understand it, but as you open your mouth, the Holy Spirit will begin. But you have to open your mouth, and then the Spirit of God will begin to speak through you in the new tongues. You may not understand it, and it's going to open you to another level. You can pray for hours. How long can you pray in your language? By 1 hour, 30 minutes, you are tired. You have said all you can. But when you begin to speak in tongues, that's where people can pray 10 hours, 5 hours, non-stop, because the Spirit of God begins to intercede through you. So today, I want to help people who want to speak in tongues. And when you get it, we are all going to pray and speak in tongues and also pray in the Spirit, pray with your language, that the Lord should baptize you, anoint you, empower you with His divine abilities, divine grace, so that you can do exploits. In this second season, I see God wanting to cause people to accomplish destiny. I don't know. I see God wanting to help people to break limitations. And you need the supernatural strength of God to do it. Without God, we cannot do it. So if you want to speak in tongues, if you want the baptism of the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues, remember, as you open your mouth and you begin to just speak, the Holy Spirit will take over. And it will just take over. And God has promises that this promise is for everybody. And the time has come, He shall pour His Spirit upon all flesh. He will pour His Spirit upon all flesh. Everyone who calls himself a child of God, who want to speak in this heavenly language, He will baptize them. So there are some of you, you come on, you speak with your own language in English and whatever, and you haven't begun to speak in tongues. It places a limit on you. You want to be able to go hours non-stop praying because the Spirit of God is now speaking also through you. So just say this after me. It is just by faith. And then you open yourself up and God begins to work in you a new thing. So if you have faith and you want to receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost with the speaking in tongues, then I'll open the line as others pray. Begin to open your mouth and speak it, and then God will speak through you, even in the name of Jesus Christ. Lift up your hands if you want to receive the anointing and the baptism of the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues. And the Bible says that if you believe, you shall receive it. If you believe, you shall receive it. Say, Lord Jesus, today, baptize me. Today, baptize me with the Holy Spirit and with your fire. Heavenly Father, today, baptize me with your Holy Spirit and with your fire. Today, I receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit and your fire in Jesus' name. Amen. If you have prayed this prayer, believe that God has given it to you. Now you have to now begin to speak it. By faith, you begin to speak it. You begin to open your mouth. You begin to open your mouth. And as you begin, the Holy Spirit will begin to work, to take control over your lips and begin to speak through you. So begin in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you. Reba satayada broskeni nemo shanda. Raba basanda. Reba bashanda. Just open your mouth. Just open your mouth. And God will begin to fill you with a new tongues in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, as the saints begin to pray, just begin to open your mouth. Rebo Shanda, Father, fill them right now. 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 Oh,
session started.
In the name of Jesus, we thank God. We thank God. When you begin to speak in this heavenly language, the Bible says that the Holy Spirit begins to make intercession for you. There are days that you don't even know what the devil is planning against you. You just have the, when you begin to speak it, immediately you realize that the Holy Spirit is interceding for you, coming between you and the obstacle that the devil was planning against you. That's why it is vital that you begin to speak it now that the Lord has baptized you, and you just do it. As you speak it, like a child speaking a new language, the more you speak it, the more you grow in the language. You grow in the language. It is a language of faith. It is mysteries. It is mysteries you are speaking. You don't understand it, but God understands it. The devil doesn't understand it. Between you and God, direct. Nobody else understands it. And with time, God will give you the speak. You realize that God will give you understanding what you are speaking to him. But it is mysteries. It's also what strengthens you spiritually and helps you to go deeper into the things of the Spirit. When you speak in this spirit, in this heavenly language, it fortifies your spirit man. And when the spirit husbands and spirit wives and demons are coming against you in your dreams, by the time they come, because you have been speaking in tongues and edifying your spirit is so strong and heavy that they cannot penetrate to do you harm. Receive it tonight. Be praying it. Be working it, praying it. It is faith. Because you don't understand, it doesn't mean that you don't have to speak it. Just speak it. And it is a new language. The Lord has blessed you. And it will take you far, even in Jesus' name. Amen. Our next prayer, we are moving on. Our next prayer, we are going to pray that in this month and this second month, God should let our glory, our hidden glory, should appear by fire. Oh, my hidden glory, appear by fire. We are going to pray that whatever has hidden your glory, any witchcraft, any wizardry, any demons that has hidden your glory in this month of May, and yes, God wants his children this month of May, and yes, God wants his children this month of May, and yes, God wants his children this month of May, and yes, God wants his children this month of May, and yes, God wants his children this month of May, and yes, God wants his children this month of May, and yes,